Shame on all three of us. We're supposed to be better than this. We're supposed to be smart. We're supposed to be intuitive. We're supposed to know sports inside and out. And we got duped by the New York Jets. They won three in a row. We started talking about, well, they'll win five in a row. Then it'll make the Raven game a really important game. Nothing. They were awful. That's a disgraceful loss yesterday. How do you even look at yourself in the mirror after you perform like that? They've done something now that has never been done by a football team in the 100-year history of the NFL. Never. They've lost to two teams that were at least 0-7 when they played them. 0-7 Dolphins, 0-11 Bengals. And they weren't even in yesterday's game. And it was coached poorly. I mean, we protect Gase a lot. The Cincinnati Bengals are one of the worst teams in football at defending the run. He never used Le'Veon Bell. Ever, ever, ever. Everything that's wrong with the Jets surfaced in that game. They were awful. Their offensive line was awful. The play calling was awful. Sam Darnold couldn't get anything done. Awful. We should be ashamed of ourselves, and I will put it upon myself to apologize to all of you that we ever got caught up in it. Because we did say one thing. Well, you could beat the Raiders, but then if you end up losing to the Bengals, it's all erased.
We did say that.
It's all erased. Those three losses mean trash right now, the three wins in a row. Absolute trash. And do either of you guys feel really good that they're going to beat the Dolphins when they play them again?
I don't know. It depends on what team's going to show up, because this is the inconsistency that's got to drive you crazy. I'm not sure what they are. Because on any given Sunday, if they play well enough, they can beat some pretty decent football teams. But if they play poorly enough, they can lose to everybody in the league.
Amazing.
So I don't even want to call them average, because average would be a compliment, because I don't think you're average when you're 4-8. You're well below average. But I will say this, looking at how things have gone since they played them, how impressive was the Dallas win? I mean, Dallas is 6-6. So you know what? On any given Sunday, the Jets can beat an average team in their building. What are the Raiders? Raiders are an average team.
They got blown out yesterday.
They might be below average, the Raiders, because the games that they won by a little, and they weren't against great teams.
But you know what, and you want to apologize and all that, I get it, but it's always a work in progress, right? I mean, you let the games play themselves out, and you see where you are. And now we look through 13 weeks, you're 4-8. As Bill Parcells always said, you are what your record says you are. But we got so giddy about the Dallas win, we got so giddy about the Oakland win, but when you look at those teams, yeah, Dallas is in first place, and yeah, the Raiders were a playoff team at the start of play yesterday, but really, what are they? They're very average. Their record says they're average. So when you play an average team in your building, then you've got a chance to beat them, and that's what the Jets did. But the Jets are also a team that if they play poorly and don't execute, they can lose to the Cincinnatis and the Miamis of the world. So that's what they are. And that's what's got to frustrate you, because it doesn't seem to be very consistent. Why is the effort so inconsistent that one day they can play with you and the next day they get embarrassed? Because that's what happened. You could talk it up. They had a couple of drop passes and all that. They were never in that game, really. Cincinnati really beat them pillar to post. They converted the thirds downs they needed to. The Jets were living three and out for most of that game. They didn't score a touchdown.
Can you believe right now the Jets are 5.5-point favorites against the Dolphins? I don't see how. If you followed their two games yesterday, how you could come to that conclusion is beyond me.
The Dolphins actually play hard. They play like a team with nothing to lose, and they have a punter shovel a touchdown pass on a fake to a kicker, all of that. I get it, because you can play loosey-goosey. But they are winning, and they do play hard. They do play hard. Yesterday, I never like to pass this judgment on a team, because you can't get inside their uniform. They didn't look like they played hard. They didn't look like they wanted it as much. And when you don't play well, sometimes that seems like that's the manifestation of it. But the first drive alone, they dropped three catchable passes.
Oh, that was bad.
And that set the tone for the entire game.
But Cincinnati had a touchdown. They dropped two. So, the Cincinnati could have scored more points. They were never in the game. So how are you not in a game against a team that hadn't won all year long? Now, I was on Friday, and I mentioned that this game did scare me a lot because I did the work, and even with a couple of games in which Cincinnati was blown out, including Baltimore, where they almost lost by 40 points, their average point of defeat is 12, which tells you that they hang around. They almost beat Pittsburgh. They're just not good enough to win the close games, but they can hang around with you. And Dalton was back, which I think inspired the team. because they didn't really seem to play for Finley, but they wanted to play for Dalton. And maybe the Jets were looking ahead to Miami, the revenge game. They walked into Cincinnati thinking it was a fait accompli. All we have to do is show up to win. And they let Cincinnati play, let Cincinnati believe they could win. And when you've got nothing to lose, you become a very dangerous team to play. And then the Jets got tight, they panicked, and they lost a game that really effectively ended their season. Because you could have played around with the game against Baltimore. Hey, they're still alive. Reason that now there's no reason. Now it's just over.
Gangrene.